Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
To my parents, Mr. Arnel Villa and Mrs. Aurelia Granil Villa, kayo po ang nagturo sa akin kung paano magmahal ng kapwa-tao. Kayo po ang nagpalaki sa akin ng may pananampalataya at takot sa Diyos. Kayo rin po ang dahilan kung bakit nagkaroon kayo ng anak na pari. Salamat po sa pahintulot ninyo na taakin ko ang buhay pagpapari. Kahit sa simula po ay masakit sa inyo. Tatangkin inang, pakawanindak ka di. Numadikman maitet, kanyayo ti amin nga kailangan niyo. Lalo pa ay di pa naglakay kan panagpaket yo. Kasla di pa ay nga dak gitaraba ko. Ngayon pamatyan nyo kuma nga madina kay baybayan ni Apo. Panggep ta panang tedyo kanyak ni Apo. Sapay la kuma taited na kada kayo amin kakailangan yo. Palakpakan po natin sila.
Today is a great day of rejoicing and thanksgiving. It is an opportune time for us to join the psalmist as he says, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord for all His goodness. His love endures forever." Let us join our brother, Reverend Edinil Dilia, SSS, as he gives thanks to God for the gift of priesthood. Let us thank his parents and family who have so unselfishly offered him for the service of the Lord and the Church. I can understand the feeling of anxiety and nervousness that he may have at this moment, as he assumes the demands and responsibilities of the priestly life. However, I tell you with full assurance, Reverend Edenil, that there is nothing to be afraid of, because God will be your strength and your shield. Trust in Him and He will help you. Jesus said, "It is not you who chose me, rather it is I who chose you and appointed you to go out and bear fruit in my name." What is expected of you after your ordination as a priest? You will find your specific functions and obligations as a priest in the Code of Canon Law. Moreover, the Church's doctrine summarizes the identity of the priest into three. Number one, the priest as the teacher of the word. Number two, the priest as the minister of the sacraments. And number three, the priest as the leader of the Christian community. As a teacher of the word, you are to preach the gospel with joy. Bring God's word to the world. It is your primary task to evangelize, to proclaim the gospel of the Lord and preach it not only with your lips, but also with your life. Priesthood is first and foremost. You are to celebrate the sacraments with faith to sanctify God's people. The mission of the Church can be summarized into two words: Salus Animarum, salvation of souls. Administer the sacraments well, avoid doing them mechanically or out of obligation, but administer them reverently and solemnly. As the leader of the Christian community entrusted to your care, you are to render service to God's people. You must be a leader like Jesus, who said that the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. As a priest, you must be willing to die to yourself. When Jesus said, come follow me, what he actually means is, come, die with me. Choosing to live by the vow of poverty means choosing a life of material simplicity, not owning anything as an individual, not accumulating wealth and possessions, sharing resources. You are not ordained priests to become rich. Choosing to live by a vow of consecrated celibacy means choosing to find fulfillment in God rather than in another person. Consecration to chastity in no way diminishes the beauty and purpose of human sexuality, but lifts up the virtue of love as a gift of oneself to God and others. To give is a sign of love, and to give something that's expensive and valuable is a sign of a great love. When you consecrate yourself to chastity, you're showing your great love for the Lord by giving up something beautiful and valuable like human sexuality and marriage. And lastly, choosing to live by a vow of obedience means choosing the will of God made manifest through your superior. The voice of your superior is the voice of God. We are celebrating today the solemnity of the Annunciation of the Lord. And Mary is the perfect example of the meaning of obedience. She totally surrendered herself to the will of God. When she said to the angel, "I am the handmaid of the Lord,
may it be done to me according to your word." Sa araw na ito po naganap ang pagtatagpo ng kalooban ng Diyos at ang kalooban ng inyong abang lingkod. Sa araw na ito, tinupad ng Diyos ang kanyang pangako. Kinasihan ako ng Diyos upang hirangin niyang maging pari ng kanyang sambayanan. Bagamat hindi po ako perpekto, madalas nadadapa, tinawag pa rin ako ng Diyos para maging isang relihiyoso ng kabanal-banalang sakramento at kanyang pinili upang maging ganap na pari.
May Mary, the Mother of God and the Mother of Priests, accompany you every day of your life and ministry. Through the affection of this tender and loving Mother, may you be joyful and faithful in your priesthood. Ask her every day to help you become holy and be conformed to her beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the eternal High Priest.